Government banks. A banknote of 5 Dragon dollars issued in 1907 by the Kingdom Yeoning Government Bank for the circulation in the Jing'an region after the launch of the self-strengthening movement. The Qing governments began initiating large industrial projects which required large amount of the capital. Though the existing domestic financial institution provided the sufficient credit and the transfer facilities to the support domestic trade and work well and with small scale enterprises, they could not meet China's new financial demand, and China turned to foreign banks for large scale and long term finance. Following up a series of military defeats, the Qing government was forced to borrow for foreign banks and syndicates to finance its indemnity payments to the foreign powers. A number of proposals were made by the modern Chinese banking institution from the 1860s onward. Lai Hung Hang, on the leader of the self-standing movement, made serious efforts to create a foreign Chinese bank, joint bank in 1885, and again in 1887 the Imperial Bank of China, first modern bank opened by the business. In the 1897, the bank was organized as a joint stock firm. It adopted the internal regulation of HSBC, and its senior manager were foreign professionals. After the proclamation of the Republic of China, the bank changed its English name to the Commercial Bank of China in 1912. The name more accurately translated its Chinese name and removed any link to the Qing dynasty. In 1905, China's first central bank was established as the Bank of the Board of Revenue. 3 years later, its name was changed to the Great Qing Government Bank, intended as a replacement for all existing banknotes. The Dang Qing Bank note was granted exclusively privilege to be used in all public and private and fund transfer, including tax payments and debt settlement. The Qing Bank was also given exclusive privilege to run to the state's treasury, the board of revenue that controlled most of the central government revenue, transferred most of its tax remittance through the bank and its branches. The government entrusted the bank with the transfer of the salt surplus taxes and diplomatic expenditures, the management of the foreign loans, the payment of the foreign indemnities, and the deposit and the transfer of the customs tax in many treaty ports. Following the Xinghai Revolution of 1911, the Qing Bank was renamed by the Bank of China. This bank continues to exist today. Another government bank, the Bank of Communication, was organized in 1908 by the Ministry of Post and Communication to raise money for the redemption of the Beijing-Hong Kong Railway from Belgian contrary. The bank aim was to unify funding for the steamship lines, railways, and as well as telegraph and postal facilities. Private bank, the first private bank, dates to 1897, courtesy of the entrepreneurship of the Shen Jinghao. Three private banks appeared in the late Qing period, all created by private entrepreneurs and without state funding. The Xinjiang Bank was established in Shanghai in 1906, followed by the National Commercial Bank in the Hangzhou the following years, and the Ningbo Commercial and the Saving Bank in 1908. In that year, the regulation of the banking registration was issued by the Ministry of the Revenue, which continued to have effects well after the fall of the Qing dynasty. A lion's share of the profitable official remittance business was taken by the Deking Bank from the Piahao Bank. Piahao Albert the disappeared, followed by the Xinghai Revolution in 1911. The same period saw the increasing power of the private interest in modern Chinese banking and the concentration of the banking capital in the Shanghai. The so-called Sultan Three Banks were established. They were the Shanghai Commercial and the Saving Bank and the National Commercial Bank and the Xinjiang Industrial Bank, and four other banks known as the Northern Four Banks emerged later. They were the Yingye Commercial Bank, the Qingqing Banking Corporation, the Central Bank, and the China and South Sea Bank, and the first three were initiated by the current and retired official of the Beijing government, whilst the last was created by the overseas Chinese